How to get started on Ticketbud and create your first event. It's free to sign up and create an event on Ticketbud. No need for credit card details. Payment information is only required when you want to start selling tickets. There's also no account needed for ticket buyers to purchase these tickets. So let's get started. Go to ticketbud.com and select Create an Event. You'll be taken to our sign-up page to provide your email address and create a password to protect your account. Welcome to Ticketbud. It's that easy. Now let's create your event. Notice at the top you have the option to skip this page and go straight to your account dashboard if you just want to look around. However, this page is really helpful to save time and get you started quicker. So fill out some event details on this page. It's just a draft and you can always edit it later. First, add your event title. Next, you can add the date and time of your event. Again, don't worry, this can be changed. Make sure it's in the right time zone. Then add your location, the venue name and address. This helps with the discoverability of your event. If it's an online event, just write that in the venue name. Next, select your event visibility. Open to the public, private, or invite only. Then you're ready to edit your event page. So now you land in your event dashboard. This is what it looks like. You have signed up and created a draft event. Here, we give you a few steps to follow to make it easy to finish setting up your event. First, confirm your email address. When you signed up, we sent you an email confirmation. So go to your email and confirm, and then come back here. Next, we're going to edit your event page. This includes adding an event description, adding a promotional banner image, and adding your venue name and address if you haven't done that already. Below is where you'll find the template for your event page. First, you'll see this large space at the top for your banner image. We'll come back to that shortly. Below that is the event title, time, date, and location. If you filled this out on the previous page, it all gets added here automatically. You can edit this directly. For example, if I decided this was no longer an online event and wanted to add a venue and address, I can just click here and change it. So the next step is adding an event description. All the details and information for your event go here. Add all the text you want. You can change the font, the size, the color of your text, so play around with it until you like how it looks. You can also add images, maps, video into this section. Just go into your saved files on your computer and upload them as you wish. You have the flexibility to create the page that you want your event goers to see. Be sure to click save after making these edits. Next, we go back up to the top to add your event banner image. This is your main promotional image for your event. Here we give you a recommended image size to ensure good visual quality. Add your photo or design from a saved file. If your photo size isn't exactly right, you are able to crop it. You can do that like this. If you'd like to create a specially designed banner to go here, there are plenty of free design tools like canva.com that you can use. We can talk about that a little more in another video. So now when we go back to the top and look at the checklist, you can see everything is checked off under the Edit Your Event page. Now is a good time to preview your live event page to see what it will look like to your ticket buyers. This is what your page looks like before you add any tickets. So now we want to go back to the next item on the list, which is add ticket types to your event. To add your first ticket or donation, you go down to select one of these buttons. Click here to add a ticket. So you'll see a new ticket window will open. Here you add the ticket title, explaining the type of ticket this is. It might be general admission, an early bird ticket, a student ticket. If you create a child's ticket, be really clear about the age range it's for. So let's make this an early bird ticket with a ticket price of $10. The ticket price is how much you want to receive for the ticket. The fees are then added automatically and the total is what the ticket buyer pays. If you want the final ticket price that the customer pays to be $10, then you just need to change that here in the total box. This then changes the price that you get for each ticket as the organizer. Most organizers pass the fees on to ticket buyers as people generally expect to pay some small online transaction fee. Next, you set the quantity for that ticket type and select Create Tickets. You can keep doing this to add more tickets and donation options. Ticketbud gives you unlimited ticket types without charging more like some competitors. You can also choose whether to display the fees at the checkout or not. You'll see that the next item on the checklist is adding a ticket description. Click the gear icon next to the ticket type to edit the settings of that ticket. Add a description for the ticket type that gives people a little bit more information about it. If you want ticket buyers to see how many tickets are left of this type, just check this box here. There are lots of other options here that you can do within ticket settings. However, you can watch another video specifically on ticketing. Here we want to keep things focused on the basics of setup. So now we've checked off the ticketing basics, next on the list is payment configuration. If it's a free event, you can skip this step. However, if you're going to sell tickets or take donations, this is how the money will be delivered to you, so you need to configure a payment processor. Ticketbud has three secure payment processor options you can choose from: Stripe, WePay, and PayPal. You'll need to consider their fees, their payout schedule, and whether they operate in your currency. Then choose the provider that best fits your needs. Select Configure to set up your account with them. Ticketbud does not hold your event money. It's secured by your chosen payment provider. Once you've chosen a provider, you can save this. Now you've completed the Getting Started checklist and you're ready to activate your event.